So the fourth dimension, depending on the irritant or exacerbation, you can have all three phases of healing taking place simultaneously, while previously injured tissue is in a separate and distinct phase at different intervals of time. I just call that vertical and horizontal healing. And so that's a question I commonly get from chiropractors is they'll say, well, what therapy do you do and when do you do it? Well, it's totally based on their biomarkers relative to the three phases of healing. And my first objective always is to get them out of pain, inflammation, decrease their muscle spasms. As soon as I can do that, I want to move them into the active motion therapy, passive motion, or not active therapy, but on an active range of motion, passive therapy, joint motion, as well as continue with any pain or inflammation or muscle spasms. And then as soon as I can, in the remodel phase, I want to get into the active therapies and the passive therapies, the elasticity. But the limiting factor is going to be, do they have the pain and discomfort? And I have to start small to make sure they don't just jump right back into a re-exacerbation. So they can have all three phases of healing going on simultaneously. What therapy you would do would be dependent on the biomarkers. But you would still want to follow the protocol. Obviously, you wouldn't want to start active therapy and do a lot of active therapy if they're still weak and in pain and inflammation. So there you have it. That's how I'm going to apply my therapeutic protocol and the reasoning behind it.